A bridge collapse in India has left at least 141 people dead. The Morbi Bridge, which ran across the Machu River in western India, collapsed on October 30th. A surveillance camera caught the moment the suspension bridge fell, plunging the pedestrians 33 feet down. Estimates say there were about 400 people on or around the bridge at the time. Footage shows survivors of the collapse clinging to parts of the bridge in the water. Reportedly, over 177 survivors have been pulled from the water so far, as well as at least 141 casualties. Officials say more dead are expected. Trained rescue crews, as well as everyday citizens, created human chains to pass victims of the collapse onto dry land. The Morbi Bridge was built in 1877. The bridge had just undergone repairs and had reopened to the public a week ago. Officials in India have arrested 9 people in connection with this tragedy. Homicide charges have been filed against the agency responsible for maintaining the bridge. An investigation is ongoing. This is Inside Edition Digital.
All right, Shalom. First off, I would like to give all glory, honor, and infinite praises unto Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Racha HaKodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that teach and rule well and labor in 100% doctrine who have learned this truth from according to the Bible. Shalom to the hopeful elect, pushing this truth and our righteousness and sincerity around the four winds of the earth. To the sincere believers in the field of Kwaf, I would like to say Shalom. I'm the brother, Ha'amayan. And Lord willing, this will be an edifying lesson. And as you can see, that particular video took place over there in India. What happened was the bridge collapsed, man, and killed a large number of people. And see, according to scriptures, guess what? Amos chapter 3 and verse 6, it says, "Shall a trumpet be blown in the city and the people not be afraid? Shall there be evil in the city? And the Lord have not done it." And the NLT version over there said, "When the ram horn blows a warning, shouldn't the people be alarmed?" And guess what? You have men of the Lord set up, man, the prophets. They back, man. Okay, out here warning you week in, week out, daily, through videos, by way of the internet, man. You hearing this warning, telling you who's doing this, who's ultimately causing these things. It says, "Does disaster come to a city unless the Lord has planned it, man?" And over here in America, which is Babylon the Great, especially Sodom and Egypt, man, a lot of events are about to take place pertaining to judgment, man. A lot of people about to be put to death, okay? The Lord is turning up, man. See what's going on? It's a lot that's going on that should have you involved and being occupied in prophecy, occupied and being in the scriptures, man, locked in the spirit, checking yourself, making sure you know you are trying to please Yahweh by Shemael Shah. Are you really doing what you're supposed to be doing? Are you really listening? Are you really being humble? Hey, it brings me into this scripture, man. Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 5, and it says, "The just Lord is in the midst thereof. He will not do iniquity. Every morning do he bring his judgment to light. He felleth not, but the unjust know of no shame." Okay. It says, "But the Lord is still there in the city, and he does no wrong. Day by day he hands down justice," man. Every day. Every day the Lord is putting somebody to death. Every day, man. And he does not fail, but the wicked know no shame, man. That's right. The unrighteous, they don't take this serious. They don't consider. Okay? You so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native American Indians. Okay, you all West Indians and Haitians, man. It's time to come back and repent, man. Be converted so your sins can be blotted out. Because these things are about to grow. Evils shall grow, man. Okay. Let me see, where is that at? Let me see. evils. Let me see if it's in. I'm looking for that particular scripture. Is it 2 Ezra 15? No, I think it's in Ecclesiastes 12. It's all good. My mind's somewhere everywhere right now. I think 2 Ezra 14. Yeah. The Wadi Habashim Abashim Kakadash. 2 Ezra 14. And verse 16, it says, "For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter," man. See? It says, "For look how much the world shall be weaker through age, so much the more shall evils increase upon them that dwell therein." See, these evils going to grow. Okay? It's going to get even worse, man. Ezekiel chapter 7 and verse 5. It says, "Thus saith the Lord power, Yahweh, and evil, and only evil, behold, is come," man. Bad times. It says, "An end is come, and the end is come. It watcheth for thee. Behold, it is come." Now, over here in the NLT version, it says, verse 5, "This is what the sovereign Lord says. Disaster after disaster is coming your way." And that's true, man. It says, "The end has come. It has finally arrived. Your final doom is waiting." So what you supposed to be doing? Repenting, seeking Yahweh by Shema Shai, crying out, man. Even for myself, first and foremost, man. Continuing to seek and please Yahweh by Shema Shai by showing him what? That you fear him, man. Okay? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, man. You want to fear Yahweh by Shema Shai. You want to show the Lord that you fear him, man. Because these things are about to take Jake unaware. Jacob's trouble is on his way. Jake is going into Jacob's trouble blind as a bat, man. And the scriptures say the blind leads the blind to a ditch, man. Okay? So you got to know who's doing this, man. Yahweh by Shema Shai, who the world incorrectly called Jesus Christ, man. What else done happen? Let's see. Wicked, abominable holidays, man. And there's so many people been put to death. Hey, man. Look at what's going on with Nancy Pelosi. Pelosi's. Let's play this. Man tased by police catches on fire. Judgment. Yeah, man.
I've always wanted to own one of these, but can I ask, like, how much do you pay in car insurance every month?
I pay $49
a month.
Ad,
man.
We now know the identity of the man charged with bursting into Nancy Pelosi's home looking for her and attacking her husband with a hammer. He's 32-year-old David Wayne DePape from Berkeley, California. He allegedly screamed, "Where's Nancy? Where's Nancy?" 82-year-old Paul Pelosi was struck on the head and torso with a hammer. The attacker reportedly tried to tie him up and wait for Nancy. Video shows shattered glass doors in the back of the house in the fashionable Pacific Heights neighborhood of San Francisco. The home invasion took place at 2:27 a.m. Friday. And look, there's an object, possibly a hammer, lying on the carpet. Paul Pelosi called 911 without the attacker realizing.
Paul Pelosi is basically trying to tell her in code what's going on. Why are you here? What are you going to do to me? I mean, you can imagine how he's trying to not let the attacker know that 911 is listening.
Our officers observed Mr. Pelosi and the suspect both holding a hammer.
The suspect pulled the hammer away from Ms. Pelosi and violently assaulted him with it. Our officers immediately tackled the suspect, disarmed him, took him into custody.
The House Speaker was at her Washington, D.C. home at the time of the attack. A spokesman said Mr. Pelosi was taken to the hospital where he is receiving excellent medical care and is expected to make a full recovery. Nancy Pelosi has a Capitol Police security detail 24/7, but they were not at the San Francisco house because she was not there.
Before we go, we want to send our best to Speaker Nancy Pelosi's husband, Paul, a lovely, lovely man who was brutally attacked in his own home in the middle of the night. Nancy's husband, Paul.
Here's what we have learned about the accused attacker. He sells hemp jewelry. He's a conspiracy theorist and espouses racist views. He's 6'2 and weighs 250 pounds. This is him dancing with the bride at a nudist wedding outside San Francisco City Hall in 2013. President.
See, that's what the hell Babylon promote, man. Pushes nothing but wickedness, man. Nothing but wickedness. This sick freak that came and burglarized, home invaded, done invaded their home, man. But guess what? Guess what, man? Guess what the scriptures say? 2 Esdras 15, and I'm going to get to the point. Matter of fact, I'm going to start at 15 for the sword. No, I'm going to start at 14. Woe to the world that and them that dwell therein, man. Destruction, great misery, distress is coming to you, man. For the sword and their destruction draweth nigh, and one people shall stand up to fight against another, and swords in their hands. It says, for there shall be sedition among men, and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power, man. They don't care about your rank, your position in the government. It says, a man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. All of these things are going to happen, man. It says, for because of their pride, their cities shall be troubled, the houses shall be destroyed, and men shall be afraid. A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor. Did that guy show pity? So imagine in Jacob's trouble, man, when it's complete lawlessness, man. No rules. Okay? But shall destroy their houses with the sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread or for great tribulation, man. This is what Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah is bringing to this place, man. He's visiting the world which he made.
Biden expressed outrage, a horrible attack, he said, adding he was praying for Paul Pelosi and Speaker Pelosi's whole family. And the FBI foiled an alleged plot to assassinate Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh in July. Nancy Pelosi was a key target of the January 6th rioters. And her home has been attacked before. The garage door was daubed with graffiti in a protest last year. And now this.
Yeah, man, a lot of them Edomites are not safe. Jake, you're not safe. No one is exempt from Jacob's trouble. So guess what? Shall there be evil in the city and the Lord have not done it, man? That should put you in a mind frame of coming back and serving Yahweh Shemayah. These people thinking can't nothing happen to them, man. You think you in good case. You think you in good case, man, because you got mansions and cameras all in your house, gated community. The Lord got the spirits created for vengeance, man. Hey, let y'all keep on playing, man. Better come back and serve y'all by Shemao Shai. What else they got, man? That's what's going on, man. All the way from India to America. It's going down, man. This lady right here done picked up an axe, smashing a home on a window. And people are finna be bugging out here, bro. What's going on the news break? Let's see. There's a few things I want to bring out in this lesson, man. Lord willing to be edifying, man, because that's what's going on. Okay. Can't forget about the war, World War III. Okay. All the rumors of wars, Russia, Ukraine, America, Israel, Iran, North Korea, China, okay, NATO and the EU. You can't forget about these things. The scriptures got an answer for everything, man. All these things are brewing up because it's leading to the day of the Lord, bro. But y'all don't want to take action and understand, man. Talking to you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native American Indians, West Indians, and Haitians, man. The mysterious fifth evangelist who created the Bible as we know it. Hey, man. One person's dead. Three people shot in the car after shooting in Brookhaven, Georgia. Hey, man. Judgment, bro. Woman shot in the head, killed at the College Park gas station. Judgment. Masha Patya, man. Hey, man. Lord ain't playing. Lord ain't playing. No game, man. Minor earthquake recorded in middle Georgia, man. These places are marked, man, because you got the men set up all over the world, man, all over the four winds of the earth, especially over here in Babylon the Great. You got camps set up all in your downtowns, okay? Chief place of concourse. This place is marked, man. Babylon the Great, Amos chapter 9, verse 8. Behold, the eyes of the Lord are upon a sinful kingdom, man. And I will destroy it from off the face of the earth, saving that I will not utterly destroy the house of Jacob, man. One third, the remnant, the hopeful elect will be protected, man. Lord willing, we'll be a part of that number. But guess what, man? America will be wiped off, knocked off, annihilated. Fuel company issued diesel shortage alert. And I'm a trucker, man. Okay. I don't drive trucks for no doggone career. Just try to take care of my house, man. Okay. But guess what? My mind ain't set on things on this earth. I'm sick of this place, man. I'm sick of this wickedness here. And it's just not because I'm making this lesson saying that, bro. Like off camera, man, I'm sick of it, man. It's lucky for me being all over the place, man. But hey, the Lord is visiting this place, man. The Lord hear our cries, man. We just got to continue to stay grounded, stay rooted, stay put, stay in our lanes. Don't do too much. You know? Don't be in the way. Scripture say, walk with wisdom towards them that are without. We got to be circumspect, man. Redeeming the times, man. Matter of fact, let me get that scripture, man. I'll close out with that. Ephesians 5 and verse 16. No, I'm going to start at 15. See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, man. So you want to be on point, exactly accurate, man. Knowing that it's a way you have to carry yourself, okay? It says redeeming the time because the days are evil, okay? You're supposed to know what's going on, man. Examine yourself. Judging, like discerning the situation, man. Discerning these things with wisdom. It's getting ugly out here, man. It's going to get worse out here, bro. We need to put on all the armor of Yahweh Shemal Shai to the best of our ability as much as we can, man, because we're going to need the Lord to protect us in the days that's to come, man. So Lord willing, y'all was edified. I would like to close out by giving all glory, honor, and infinite praises unto Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Rachah HaKodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that teach and rule well and labor in 100% doctrine. How I learned this truth from according to the Bible. Charlotte Wong to the hopeful elect, pushing his truth and our righteousness and his sincerity around the four winds of the earth. To the sincere believers in the few Akwaf, I would like to say Charlotte Wong. Babaka Shah, Babaka Shah, Babaka Shah, Baba Bao, Kwame Asharala, Barak Kyle Akin, DTA to this place, America. Shalom.